Workshop on myeloid development provides a forum for discussion with the experts.
What this is really a best of ASH for people interested in myelopoiesis, how myeloid cells develop and what goes wrong in acute myeloid leukemia.
This is kind of semi-informal and formal, and people have very short talks, so information is really concentrated. We learn a lot, from each other's, a year's new development.
Big ideas and questions were raised in an interactive environment, and new findings provided unique insight for attendees, some research released for the very first time.
Usually it's revealed for the first time here. We like to make sure that people present things that are not yet published.
Session leaders from prestigious research institutions summarized current questions and lead discussions on how to best answer those questions based on recent findings. Attendees from clinical and laboratory backgrounds exchanged ideas with experts and investigators, as well as students.
I think it's very important for us to come here to listen to the most updated data here. And you can see a lot of people here, the expert.
The workshop's format included 5-hour-long sessions divided up into condensed mini-sections to cover the latest research in hematopoiesis, stem cell biology, transcription factors and epigenetics, signaling animal models, and myeloid malignancies.
For me, myeloid neoplasms and essentially the regulation of how a stem cell, hematopoietic stem cell, can go awry to produce a neoplasm. Basically anything that's in that whole range of topics is very important.
Over 12 years running, this workshop was yet another successful meeting of the minds on myeloid development and progress.
From an ethical perspective, we're sparing an expected 10 patients.
In keeping with their commitment to professionals entering the field of hematology, ASH kicked off Trainee Day, which gave attendees practical applications through a didactic session on trial design and statistics.
I think there's a research readiness in young investigators that they get to a certain point and things that they've heard before that didn't make a whole lot of sense now are starting to say, I need to understand this. I'm seeing papers about this. I want to investigate this myself. And suddenly that information has much more meaning.
I feel like I learned a lot, and hopefully I can apply that knowledge to my work, my research, designing my own experiment, and hopefully running big experiment on my own lab.
What questions could I ask that would help me either prove that my hypothesis is correct or disprove my hypothesis?
ASH does wonderful effort in both training in clinical research and training in translational research. These talks are globally applicable to the trainees, and I think that makes it a very important thing to do.
Does that answer your question?
The informative lectures are followed by a question and answer session before trainees head to several breakout sessions, which cover everything from alternatives in lab funding, assembling research teams, to the basics of finding a job and career development.
The trainees come and they make connections with the other trainees. I think this is enormously important. So they might find out that someone has found a particular program or a particular workshop you can apply to. Terribly helpful. It's a networking component that I think is very important for these trainees.
I think we have to consider that it may be feasible.
I've always been interested in sort of the clinical side of science that I don't get to see every day. So I think this is a very good opportunity for me to learn about these things that I don't get to learn on a daily basis.
So, does the world's premier hematology conference hit the bar for entertaining and informative sessions?
Yeah, I'm getting a good knowledge, good exposure in this conference.